And there's another completion.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
They'll look to throw now on first down. That's complete into the hands of Myers. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard at the 30.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is what every back in the league is supposed to do, exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9.
And 9 at the Jets' 31-yard line.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 19.
For a Patriot.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He'll fight his tight end here, Asiasi. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get about 4 down inside the 10 to the 9. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. The quick slant caught. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal.
2-yard line.
They'll set up to throw. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Tyus Bowser came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. He'll buy some time right, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Their mobile quarterback with touchdown number 2 in the game, and now 11 on the year as his guys continue to pour it on. The first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
No. Davis from the top rope. I like it. Been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And in the end, the finishing touch, an 11-yard run. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Ballantyne to return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Back now in Foxborough. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter, a very one-sided affair.
check. Mike 21.
From the 27, Young, and he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
An 8-yard pickup. First down, Jets.
Here's Young from the shotgun. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Partney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
He'll get this to Lazard.
Young's pass.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Now he dumps this off over the middle, and he gets it down to the 32. That catch good for only a couple. Now second and 8 at the 32-yard line.
At the 32-yard line.
Again, it's Young. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Boy, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. It'll be Young again. That's complete to the tight end, Everett.
Young's pass.
A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Got a man, it's Berrios complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And the Jets first down.
They go play action, Young. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked.
Some 14 on the play.
And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hasn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense, I got it.
You see what I did there?
Yeah, he needs better protection, that's for sure. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24.
Another try after the first down sack. Young. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
And you have to wonder, Charles, in a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
Now they try the right side here. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. He got maybe a 0.5 yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you. and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
At the 15-yard line, the Jets take over first and 10.
Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He'll find Everett there, complete.
Young's pass.
A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Out of the gun, it's Young.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
7 yards, the pick up there. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
36-yard line.
They'll throw again. Young. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 6 yards, the pick up, and that's a first down.
It's a gain of 6. First down, New York.
To the air once more, Young. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Another try after the first down sack. Young working the middle here. That's complete to Everett, the tight end.
Young's pass.
An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down.
And it's third
throwing. Young. And that will be incomplete.
Young's pass. Incomplete. Rings up.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. But we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down in this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0-2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. This game is all but over after that last fourth down stop. The only question left, will they play conservative and run the clock or try to pour some salt in the wound? From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
Second and 11. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
And
they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other. But it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Good starting position for the Jets as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. following the interception. Young, that's complete to Lazard. They showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry.
Second and one at their 49.
Throwing again on second down. Young, and Jones has it over the middle. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
A gain of five. First down, Jets.
Here is Young. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
19 Tiger.
Now a first down throw for Young. He's got the hook up to Lazard. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three.
Second and three at the Patriots 19.
Now it's Edwards. And he stopped after a gain of one. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down.
The tackle made by Patrick Chung.
Young on third and two. Got a man. It's Mims. And the Jets are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on third and one.
Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Off the play fake, Young. Able to shake him off. Now Young loses the football. It's stripped. But I think a Jet was able to recover, and they'll keep possession thanks to a heads-up play.
Now as we look down, it appears we've got a Jet shaking up on the play. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough.
Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Now it's the backup, Newton. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. Third and goal, trying to make that scoreboard at least a little more respectable. A shotgun snap for Newton. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
But they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
It's 41, Jets 10.
Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
New England trotting into place on offense, and it's looking all the more likely that a fifth straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Patrick Onwuazor on the tackle. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and nine at the 26.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28 yard line.
He was brought down at the 28 yard line. A gain of two. Brings up third and seven.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's a 7 yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
I've got an idea. Let's skip racing to the airport at the end of this game. Let's go to the post game press conference. I have a feeling that the quarterback of this winning team is going to be giving a whole lot of credit to the running game and the offensive line.
Yeah, I was just going to say the offensive line, yes, carrying the ball has been key, but those guys up front, they've made a lot of space. That they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Pats, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Tennessee Titans. Meanwhile, for the Jets, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And perhaps fortunately for them, they'll get an early bye next week and come back to action in week 7. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
You get down with-